What's going on, guys? This is Darian with Darian the Dev. Welcome back to my channel, and in this video I want to talk to you guys about what's stopping you from learning how to program. I just want to share these things because I've seen it happen a lot, and I think it's important to be aware of it so that when it comes up or when you start noticing that you're doing these things, you can catch yourself and you can stop and, you know, think differently about it, because, you know, these things can really stop you and hold you back and put you in the wrong mindset to become a programmer. So the first thing I want to talk about, guys, is obviously going to be imposter syndrome, right? So do you feel like you're a fraud, or do you feel like you're not really a developer because you've only built a single page website? You know, is that stopping you from continuing? Is that stopping you from seeking out answers? Is that stopping you from asking people questions? Is that stopping you from building new things and not just that one website? A big reason why I think imposter syndrome is so important to actually talk about and be aware of is because you have control over your attitude, right? There's not a lot of things in life that we really get to control, but our thoughts and our attitude is one of those things, right? And so imposter syndrome kind of ties into the other points I have for this video too, but when you are not convinced yourself that you're good enough, you're not going to convince someone else that you're good enough, whether that's a client or an employer. It's just not going to happen, right? And when you convince yourself that you're not good at something, doesn't matter what you build, you're not going to be happy with it. You're not going to be pleased with it. So you might even find yourself doing that. You build projects and you're actually learning, but it's not Facebook or it's not Twitter. So you feel like you didn't build anything relevant. And that's really a bad one, guys, because perfectionism, if that's a thing, when it comes to programming, is not going to be good, guys, because there is no perfect. Everyone's going to make mistakes. It's part of learning. It's how you get to that intermediate level or that senior level. It's going to be from making a lot of mistakes. It's not because they're so much smarter than you. They've just made a lot more mistakes over the long period of time they've been programming. So if you're stuck in the imposter syndrome mindset, or you catch yourself just being really negative about everything that you do, or you're immediately thinking negative before you even get started about something, or you think it's too hard, or you say it's too hard, or say, oh, I'm not a math person, coding's not for me, or I don't know, software developer, yeah, I don't know, like, you gotta know JavaScript, you gotta do this and do that. I mean, and that's true, but start somewhere, right? Like, I mean, what's wrong with HTML and CSS in the beginning until you get to JavaScript, right? Like, it's just about breaking the problem down into smaller, more manageable pieces and then chipping away at that. So imposter syndrome and managing that is definitely gonna be the first thing that could really be holding you back from jumping into programming or becoming better if you're already programming. The next one that I have, like I said, it kind of goes hand in hand a little bit with imposter syndrome, but it's going to be negative self-talk, right? So literally blaming yourself for things, or literally saying like, oh, I suck, or I don't get this, or I don't know how to do that. I've never done that before. Like, those types of things, even though it might not feel like it, guys, it's putting you in a really negative space. It's putting you in a really negative mindset, because I can't, I don't know, I've never, like, those sentences are literally starting off with a negative tone, right? So the more that you incorporate that negative tone, that negative energy, those negative words into your thinking while you're trying to learn programming or code, subconsciously you don't understand how much easier you're making it for yourself to just quit, because you haven't even been speaking of programming or coding or the things you're learning as positive. Like, you're literally speaking of them as negative experiences. You're not saying, oh my god, like, I didn't know this yesterday, but I learned this today, so wow, I get it. Sometimes you want to get excited about big goals and big outcomes, but guys, sometimes the little things that count, right? Like, sometimes those big learning, like, especially the better you get at programming, those big, like, aha moments are going to become, like, further and few in between. So there's going to be a lot more, like, micro rewards or micro lessons that you learn in between those big aha moments, the better you get at programming. So if you're waiting on that big aha moment every single time just to feel good about what you're learning, it's not gonna cut it, guys. You're really gonna get down on yourself, and you're gonna get burned out, and you're gonna get tired, and you're gonna just say forget programming. So in any scenario possible, try to reward yourself as much as possible, whether that's with positive speak about yourself, or positive speak about the work that you're doing, or positive speak about what you're actually practicing, what you're actually learning. Reward yourself for the process. Be proud of yourself for the process that you're going through, not so much the outcome itself, if that makes sense. So eliminating negative self-talk is going to be the second thing. The last thing is a really, really big one. Again, sort of kind of ties into imposter syndrome a bit, but are you afraid of what other people are thinking about you or your skills as a developer? Are you afraid of being judged by other people because you're trying to learn web development, or you're telling people that you're becoming a software developer? Does that still feel wrong to say? Do you feel like you're lying? Do you feel like a fraud? What is it, right? Because at the end of the day, if you tell someone you're becoming a software developer but you're not there yet, what do they care, right? Like, who does that really affect them? Whether you're actually learning programming or not, how does that affect that person? Okay, you told them you're becoming a software developer. And like, what? And what else, right? Like, no one cares. Like, no one really cares as much as we probably think that they do. So if you're feeling that imposter syndrome, or if you're feeling that fear of being judged by other people for doing a career transition, so maybe you're like a nurse or a lawyer or something, but you want to start learning how to code, and you're worried that people are going to ask you, like, oh, why are you going to quit nursing? Why are you going to quit being a lawyer? Blah, blah, and all this stuff. Like, why? Why do you even, like, why do you care? This is your journey, right? Like, this knowledge is going to live in your head once you learn it. They have nothing to do with it. Whether they hate it or love it, it really doesn't matter. It's up to you to go out there and find the resources. I mean, whether you're a senior developer or a junior developer, right? To a person who doesn't code, you're a developer, right? It doesn't matter the depth of your knowledge. You know more than they do, right? And you actually know how to take a text editor and build something with it. A website, a button to click, like whatever. Which the average person probably can't do, or the average person cannot do. So, hey, why worry about what they have to say or what they think about it? This is your journey. This is your story that you're going to tell one day. Hopefully, you're going to share it with people like how I'm sharing this with you. So don't let someone else's opinion of what you're doing slow you down, discourage you, or stop you from doing either what you're doing or what you want to do. Because at the end of the day, it has nothing to do with them, guys. This is your journey. This is your story. This is your life, your career. So own it, do it. Be proud of yourself. Reward yourself. Speak nicely to yourself. Be kind to yourself. That's all I got for today, guys. I hope this video was helpful. Make sure to leave me some comments down below in the comment section. Let me know what you guys think about this. Also, check out the freebie section down in the description where I give away free stuff. So make sure you guys check that out. Lastly, if you guys enjoyed this video at all, please leave me a like, share, and subscribe. It really helps me just with the motivation to keep making these videos for you guys. And this is Darian again with Darian the Dev, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.